Hello, everybody. Welcome to Mindful Monday. I'm trying to see my best angle here. Hi, I've got pigtails today. I took Michael to the airport. He's going back to Belize today. So I've been running around, just did a coaching session already. And now I'm talking to you, and I want to talk to you today about menopause. And I, instead of calling menopause, I want to call menopause menopositivity, and my podcast is dedicated to helping you get through menopause and to help you get through it and transition. Hi, Cindy. And transition in a way that is really going to help you in the next phase of your life. And for many of the women that I work with, and if you're one of them, one of the biggest problems is weight gain. And if you are one of those people and you've been struggling with weight your whole life, menopause is not a time. It's not a happy time because it's really hard to lose weight. But here's the deal. The podcast that I do is to help you connect to your body, because I think for a lot of us, we've never really been connected to our bodies. And when we go through menopause, it is a huge disconnection. But because we have so many different kinds of symptoms, some of them are not that sweet, we get an opportunity to pay attention because our body is screaming at us, sleeping, all kinds of issues. We're depressed, we're not sleeping, we're gaining weight, all those lovely things, losing our sex drive. But all of these things can be rectified and taken care of by paying attention to your body. And hi, Diane. And the deal with weight loss, really, during menopause, one of the biggest things is not so much what you're eating, but what you're thinking and what you're making it mean. I just finished a class with 10 unbelievable women. Hi, Carol. And one of the things that I noticed about these women is they were pissed off. They were pissed off because they were going through menopause and they were pissed off at their bodies. And one of the things that we really, really worked on in this class is, what are you pissed off about? Your body is getting your attention for a reason. Your body's probably been trying to get your attention for many, many years, and you just kind of ignored it. And I think with eating, it's one of the biggest things that we've done to ourselves is we just don't pay attention to ourselves. Yes, Diane, I'm going to be offering that class again. Yeah, I know. I really think you'll like it. It was really fantastic. So Diane was asking me about the class that I just finished, The Science of Body and Mind. And it really, I guess the beauty of it was, is that everybody was in different places, but some of the things that were, everybody was the same, is good. One of the things that was the same was, is that they were, didn't like their bodies, they were pissed off at their bodies, and they were trying to figure out how they, you know, that they just had to eat less and they just couldn't eat the foods that they wanted anymore, and poor, poor me. This is what you learn. No, poor, poor you. You are in a position to change everything. And you can use this time to put your attention into your body and figure out what it needs. And it starts with listening to it. I tell you what, your body knows everything. It knows, it tells you what to do. You're just not listening. So what I want you to do this week, and this is just the basics, is I want you to tune into your body when it says it's hungry, and I want you to tune into your body when it says it's full. The most simple thing you can do, if you can pay attention to those signals, there are so many other signals involuntary going on in your body that you are not paying attention to that you need to. For instance, what do you do when you're tired? Now, I've spent a lot of time with clients talking about, what do you do when you're tired? Like, I don't think it's rocket science. There's only one thing you do when you're tired. You put your body down. You put it to rest. But you know what half the people do that I talk to? Everybody in my class, you know what they do when they're tired? They think they need something to eat to keep them up. That's what they tell themselves. Brilliant, smart women tell themselves, oh, I just need some M&Ms so I can feel better, so I can get my work done. I just had a call like that. It's not going to work. So you've got to start noticing it. So for this, I put my podcast up just on, I think it's on the physical hunger scale, the one that I put up again. It's the basics for those of you who've been listening to the podcast. Go back to the beginning, because that's what I'm talking about here, is when you're hungry, eat. When you're stop, when you're full, stop. -2 start, +2 stop. What does that feel like? and then see the emotions that are going on, that if you're not hungry, why are you eating? Now, one of the biggest emotions, I will tell you, tired, exhausted. That's an emotion. It turns into a strong emotion. If you're tired or exhausted, you need to close your eyes. That's what you need to do. You need to close your eyes. You can sit down and you can meditate for 5 or 10 minutes. You can lay down and take a nap for 20 minutes. Or if it's nighttime and it's 8:30 and you say, oh, that's too early. I can't go to sleep at 8:30. Yeah, well, maybe you need to go to bed at 8:30. Instead of deciding when it's time to eat and when it's time to sleep, listen to your body and see if you can start paying attention to it. Okay, so I'm not going to scream and yell at you because I am a kind, kind coach. I just want you to start loving on your body, and I want you to start paying attention to it. That's Mindful Monday for today. Pay attention to your bodies. Next week, we'll talk a little bit more about emotions and what you can do about it. And know that menopause is a time to pause, and it's time to take a positive outlook on what you can do for your body to make this phase the very, very best part of your life. Bye, guys.